Hello, and welcome to Unexplained Possibilities, in case you missed it, for June 2018. I'm Melvin, and let's not waste any time and jump right into it. June was a very off month for Unexplained Possibilities. I was feeling a little under the weather, guests canceled, and we were barely able to get a podcast out in the last second. The podcast saw a return of Benny donning his hero cape and saving the day. We had a very fun talk about demons, aliens, and conspiracy theories. Benny, if you're listening, thanks again, man, for coming in when you did. Otherwise, June would not have had a show. The other small piece of content we uploaded was the answer for our Too Crazy to Believe shipwreck cannibals. If you're following along with the story, then be sure to check out the answer to find out if it's true or too crazy to believe. And that's it for Unexplained Possibilities. Like I said, it was an off month, but July things should pick back up. Now, moving on to a few events from around the world that caught my eye. There was a UFO encounter in Oregon this month, and not just spotting a UFO, but an actual close encounter of the third kind. A 12-year-old girl was with her family in the hills a few miles from Silas, Oregon. The girl was the first to see a strange-looking creature, and then her mother and her mother's boyfriend saw it. According to them, what they saw was 4 to 5 feet tall, it was a pale gray color, and its skin was so thin it was almost transparent. The being was also very skinny. It stood about 100 feet from the 12-year-old girl's mother's car. Then it almost immediately vanished. The 12-year-old girl said she saw it 2 more times before hearing some type of buzzing noise and then strange echoes, and finally quiet. The family no longer saw the creature after that. The sketch you see is a depiction of what the family claims they saw. Speaking of UFOs, July 2nd is UFO Day. So, all you sky watchers out there, have your telescope and cameras at the ready. You never know who or what will give you a light show. Moving from the sky to land, archaeologists have made a grand discovery. An ancient Roman artifact known as the Hand of God was discovered near Hadrian's Wall in England. The hand is a symbol of the god Jupiter, and was often mounted on the top of a pole and used to bless or sanctify his followers during religious rituals inside his temples. The hand was found deposited in a small bog, almost certainly as part of a religious ritual to mark the completion of a temple dedicated to the god just 15 meters away. For those of you interested in the paranormal and you're in Michigan, take a trip over to Grand Haven Convention Center to take part in Michigan's Ghost Coast Paranormal Convention. What makes this paranormal convention so unique is that they don't focus on celebrities and stars from paranormal TV shows. No, instead, they bring in experts from the field that the general public can speak to and even take part in 3 workshops. This is a great way to get hands-on and gain knowledge about the paranormal world. Finally, it would appear that my co-host Rose has been pulling a fast one on us all. According to the Flat Earth Society, Australia doesn't actually exist, and people claiming to be Australian are paid NASA shields. Flat Earther Shelley Floord states, and I quote, "It's a hoax made for us to believe that Britain moved over their criminals to some place. In reality, all these criminals were loaded off the ships into the waters, drowning before they could see land ever again. It's a cover-up for one of the greatest mass murders in history. All things you call proof are actually well-fabricated lies made by the leading governments of the world. Your Australian friends are all actors and computer-generated personas. If you think you've ever been to Australia, you're terribly wrong. Pilots have in fact been flying to other islands or parts of South America where they have cleared space and hired actors to act out as real Australians. Australia is a code word for the cold-blooded murder of more than 100,000 people, and it's not okay. I legit have no words to describe what I just read. So instead, I will conclude it here. Thank you so much for checking out In Case You Missed It for June 2018. And if you haven't done so already, be sure to follow Unexplained Possibilities on Facebook and Twitter, and we'll be seeing you in July.